So the number system basically contains the decimal number with a base of 10, if you see, binary number with a base of 2, octal with a base of 8, and hexa with the base of 16. How it comes? Because when we just write the binary information, then it lies in the form of 1 and 0 only. Octa is 2 raised to the power 3. It is represented in the bits of 3. So it gives the base of 8. And here it gives the base of 16. So if you see the counting, the decimal number system is simply written from 0 to 16. There is no change in the value. But whenever you do the binary number, you can write it in the 8421 concept. As I have told in the class that 8421, and to understand the 8421 concept, you can watch the video from my channel, that is the online electro. So if you want to write the 10, you can write 1010. Here they mention the 10 as a 1010. So for the more details and for the more information, please watch the video of 8421 concept on my channel. Next is the octal number system. In octal number system, they represent 0 to 7 in a similar way, but after 7, they write the 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, which shows that 8 or 9 are not octal number system. Why so? Because if I just want to write 7, then I can represent it in 3 bits. But if I want to represent 8, then it needs a 4 bit at least. Because if I just cross it, then it becomes a 0. It never ever forms a 8. So in order to represent 8 and 9, we need at least 4 bit. If I just talk about the 10, we can write it separately in a group of 3 bits, which become it is 1 and it is 0. So in octal number system, we can't show 8 and 9, but yes, we can show other numbers. Here, if you see that after 17, we are just showing 20, means 18 and 19 are not octal number, because again the same reason is 8 and 9 needs 4 bit for their representation. Rest all the things need 3 bits for their representation. If you see the hexadecimal number system, it shows the A to F special characters after the 9. But the main focus of concern is that how I write this 16 into the 10. So we will discuss into the conversion system. But for your information, when we convert decimal to hex, at that time, we are just dividing it with the 16. If I am having 16 as a value, and if I just want to convert decimal into the hex, so divided 16, 1, the 16, and remainder is 0. So I can write it in 1 and 0 form. Fine. Same happens with the 17, because when I write 17 and divide by 16, the 16, 1 is 16, remainder is 1. Then 17 is represented by the 1, 1. So in this way, we can convert the decimal number into the hexadecimal one and the representation as well. Similar for the octal and for the binary. So these are basically the number systems. Next is the decimal number system. As I told you that its base or radix is 10. Fine, we can represent it from 0 to 9. Next is binary number, its base is 2. We can say its radix is 2, and example is the whole thing is in the form of 0 and 1, nothing else. Next, binary number system is represented in the form of bit 0 to bit 7. The bit 0 is called the least significant bit, and bit 7 is called the most significant bit. The most important part which you have to know, that group of 4 bit is known as nibble. Group of 8 bit is known as byte, and group of 16 bit is known as word. Fine. So you have to remember these, that what is the concept of this bits and byte. A group of bit is known as byte. Fine. And group of 4 bit is known as nibble. Sorry. The binary number system, as I told you, that bit 0 is called the LSB and bit 7 is called the MSB. LSB stands for the least significant bit, MSB for the most significant bit. Fine. So this is again the 8421 concept, as I told you in the previous lecture, that how we just take the values with the base of the 2. Because in the binary number system, we are just dealing with the place of the 2. These are the weighted codes. A specific weight is assigned to a specific bit. So if I just move for the bit 8, then the I just take the 2 raised to power 8, and then 2 raised to power 16, then 2 raised to power 32, and all. So in this way, I can proceed. Octal number system base is the 8, and it represent from 0 to 7, then 10 to 17, then 20 to 27. We never ever take the 8. Here you can see the example that 9, 8, 3, 8, this is incorrect. The reason being, we can't represent 8 in the octal form, because in octal we need 3 bits to represent, but to represent 8, we need at least 4 bits. So this question is wrong. The similar question may be asked in the STs or the N term. At the time, you have to write the reason for that, why you are not representing this into the octal form. Fine. So next is the hexadecimal. In hexadecimal, we are having the value 0 to 9. And after 9, we are just representing it with the special characters, that is A, B, C, D, E, and F. Fine. So hexadecimal number, A is equivalent to 10, B is equal to 11, C is equal to 12, and many more. Fine. And 16 is again represented in the form of 10 when we just counted into the decimal one. So this is basically a number conversion. This number conversion, if we see, is of 12 types. For example, if I am having this number system, it is represented into four forms: decimal, binary, octal, hex. Now decimal is further divided into decimal into binary, decimal to octal, decimal to hex. Then binary to decimal, binary to octal, binary to hex. Further, octal to decimal, octal to binary, octal to hex. Next, hex to decimal, hex to octal, and hex to binary. So these are the types. Fine. So when we deal about these things and these first three things, we have to remember one point. Fine. These six conversions are similar. We need to just learn one of the checkpoint for these six conversions. So let's see the next slide for this. This slide shows that if you want to convert decimal to octal, then at that time I divide it with the 8. This diagram shows that when I just need decimal to octal, I divide it by 8. Decimal to binary, I divide by 2. Decimal to hexadecimal, divide by 16. When I do the vice versa, at that time, octal to decimal, I multiply by the 8 raised to the power 0. Then binary to decimal, I multiply by the 2 raised to the power 0. And hexadecimal, 16 raised to the power 0. So let's take an example. For example, if I am having value that I have to convert 256.10 decimal to, you know, binary. At the time, I just divide 256 with the base of the 2 because I have to convert it into the binary form. So just divide it 128, the remainder is 0. Further divide it, remainder is 0. Further divide it, remainder is 0. Then at last we reach to this level where I find this result. Now you have to write from lower to the upper one. 1, 1, 2, 3. How many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So write 8 zeros. Now, what to do with this 0.10? Then we multiply it with the 0.10 into the 2. It gives 0.20. Then further, 0.20 into 2, it gives 0.40. Then 0.40 into 2, that is 0.80. Then 0.80 into further 2, that is 1.60. How we write it? We just take the first value of these decimal numbers. So I write it in the form of 0001. One thing you have to remember is then when we just divide it before the decimal value, then we go the approach or we choose the approach from bottom to the top. Otherwise, we choose the top to bottom approach. So this is the case for others also, so that when you just divide it with, or you want to convert it into the octal form, then you divide it with the 8 similar format, or here you multiply it with the 8, or whenever you want it in a hexadecimal, then you divide it with the 16. And here you can multiply with the 16. Fine. So it depends what exactly you want. Fine. So let's do the reciprocal of it. So let me erase whole. Okay. So let me do one of the example. For example, if I'm having 256.10 into the decimal, if you want to convert it into the 16, then divide. What will be the value? It become, if you see, so just divide it. Meanwhile, let me do here that what exactly it is. It shows a 1.60. Then I have to proceed the decimal value, nothing with this one. It gives 9.60. Fine. So I have to write the answer in this way. I have to multiply it and then I have to write it in this form. So just wait for the 2 minutes. Okay. So when I just multiply it, it is 16, where remainder is 0. Fine. Nothing to do further. If I divide it with the 1, then it gives this value. So I write 100.19, the base 16. Means when I convert 256 into the hexadecimal, at the time I obtain this result at 100.19. So similar with the octal number. So let's do their vice versa. Okay, so if I am having a number, for example, 80. If I am having, let's take 405. If I am having 405.10, 405.1 into the 8 form, I have to convert into the decimal. If question come in this way, then what should be the my action? That I have to multiply this point with 8 raised to the power 0, this with 8 raised to the power 1, this with 8 raised to the power 2. Fine. And after point, I have to divide it with 8 raised to the power 1. What should be the answer, right? When 8 raised to the power 0 is 1, 1 into 5 is 5. Plus 8 raised to the power 1 is 8, 8 into 0 is 0. 8 into 8 is 64, and when I multiply 64 with the 4, then it gives the 256. Now, what to do with this? Here I am having 1 by 8, so just divide it. For example, if you are having 1 by 8, let me do that is 1 divided by 8 is 0.125. So I just take the value 0.125 and then add all other values, that is 256 plus 5, that is equivalent to 261.125, that is the base of 10. So in this way I can do with the 2 raised to power. For example, if this question comes to the base of the 2, with the base of the 16, then what to do? I multiply with 16 raised to the power 0, 16 raised to the power 1, 16 raised to the power 2, and then I divide it with the 16 raised to the power 1, and similar way I will calculate the whole answer.